Good afternoon. My name is Luis Dauri Hallenbeck. I'm Sales Director and Operations Director of Marcha Galha do Brasil. I'm here with my colleague Davis Cornelius, President of Marcha Galha USA, and we will present an overview on our South American production and specialties. Then David will focus on North American market and U.S. plant in Manhall. Let's start with a picture of the market situation in Brazil. The apparent steel consumption in Brazil, as you can see, is a little bit stable since 2007. Nowadays it's a challenge to Brazil, because since 2010 to 2011, we have a decreasing of this market around 11%. We have the cold rolled and the galvanized material have suffered more during the year, with minus 20% and 13%. The balance of the steel trade in Brazil today shows a growing share of imports from other countries starting from 2009 and continuing today. We look forward to a period where Brazilian economy is facing a new challenge to revert the biggest challenge, the deindustrialization there, because the steel is coming to Brazil as parts and components. But if we move on the tubes market, we estimate the carbon steel tubes up to 7 inches diameter growing in 2012 by around 5% if compared to 2011, with peaks in March and August. Going to stainless steel tubes up to 6 inches, we expect a similar situation with total increase of 5% on the past year. Here, the market is approximately divided 63% for 300 series and 37% for 400 series. Imports from foreign producers today represent 20% of the market. That should reach a total amount of 44,000 tons of stainless steel tubes. Next. Within this picture, Marcha Galha do Brasil operates today with a very wide range of products. But let's go back to the beginning for Ahuai. We can say that Marcha Galha do Brasil was the first large greenfield investment launched outside Europe by Marcha Galha. This is the inauguration. I was here. The plant was inaugurated in October 2000. This is the photograph. And is located in Garuva, state of Santa Catarina, in the south of Brazil. From a logistics point of view, we can count on 3 major harbors near the plant: São Francisco do Sul, Itajaí, and Paranaguá. Since then, the plant has been constantly upgraded, and in the last 2 years, the surface has been doubled. Now, the total covered area is 120,000 square meters on a total area of 220,000 square meters. And we have more than 700 workers between engineers, technicians, and machine operators. we can calculate a total of 420 million reais invested by Martegalha until now in our plant. That is more than 175 million euros. And today the range includes carbon steel, stainless steel tubes, tubes for refrigeration and components for the industry of white goods, structural sections, and narrow strips and sheets. If we go into details for carbon steel tubes, we can count on 5 lines for tube up to 7 inches with capacity of 200,000 tons per year. Technical specification go from industrial use to precision round and shaped to fluid carrying systems. Then, we should not forget our specialization in the refrigeration industry. It was our beginning. Here we have 2 refrigeration tube lines for more than 240 million meters of capacity per year and 8 lines for welding condensers for refrigeration that we engineer together with our main customers, producing about 7 million pieces per year. The flat set area has also been developed with 3 slitting lines for narrow strips and our capacity is to cut the material for all of our tubes plus 45,000 tons for commercialization of strips. We have also 3 blank cutting machines with capacity also 200,000 tons of capacity plus 1 new machine for structural sections. On the stainless steel side, next please. The production was started 5 years ago and now is equipped with 6 lines for tubes up to 6 inches for a total 20,000 tons capacity a year. Speaking of application, we can say the most important for Martegalha remain automotive with tubes and flat products of tight tolerance, cut to length and special delivery conditions. Petrochemical, here we have last year recently completed accreditation CRCC, that means to be included as suppliers for the industry, referring to Petrobras, the most important national player in the energy sector. Sugar and alcohol sector connected to the food and dairy, where we are also present, that are now strongly growing in Brazil. For us is a very important segment. Agricultural and motorway and construction also rising in all the nation. The white goods sector, where we have our presence since the start of Martegalha do Brasil, with components and tubes, and we have homologation for all world-class manufacturers. But also civil construction and machinery and the furniture sector and of course distribution. So we can say that Martegalha do Brasil has now consolidated its presence at national level among the top 10 independent steel processing companies with a gross turnover of 513 million reais. For the future, we expect to perform sales for 650 million reais, that is about 275 million euros by the end of this year, shipping more than 200,000 tons of steel products. Of course, we look mostly to added value sectors such as petrochemical, where we have our most recent certification, and we plan to increase our base of active customers that today is over 1,100 units, not only in Brazil, but also in Argentina, Colombia, Costa Rica, El Salvador, Mexico, United States, and as far as South Africa. Let me thank you for your attention. And now, Mr. Cornelius is going to illustrate our production in Martegalha, USA. Thank you.
Thank you, Luis. Good afternoon, everyone, and thank you very much for attending this afternoon. I'm Dave Cornelius, and I represent Martegalha, USA. Please let me briefly describe the North American production, the specialties we are currently working on, and their markets. We should mention, first of all, that we are part of the same stainless steel production network that includes 8 processing plants worldwide. All of these plants are part of a unique network of know-how and competence that sets Martegalha apart from other processing companies. They are arranged to make sure that each plant can ensure the same quality level of products and services worldwide. We can achieve this thanks to our shared knowledge, our shared quality procedures, and our shared learning activities. And recently, we have also expanded our carbon steel production, where the same company principles are applied. First, let's have a look at our domestic market for stainless steel. We operate in a market in terms of welded stainless steel pipe in our size range with an overall volume of about 95,000 short tons in 2011. Of these 95,000 tons, approximately 40% were imported primarily from Asia. If we speak of stainless tubing instead, grades A249 and A554, which exclude automotive, the total volume is estimated to be 100,000 tons for 2011. We estimate our total market share in the U.S. of stainless steel products is about 30%. The Martegalha USA production facility is located in Munhall, Pennsylvania, which is 8 miles from downtown Pittsburgh. As a company, it was integrated within the Martegalha network during the 1990s. It is now devoted to the manufacturing of stainless steel, duplex, and high nickel alloy pipe and tubing, and also galvanized tubular products for a wide range of applications. The production area spreads over 31 acres of land with covered buildings of over 300,000 square feet. The facility, employing over 130 workers, has a yearly output capacity of over 60,000 tons of finished product. We operate through 16 tube welding lines, and we also have an area for finishing and testing equipped with 3 eddy current stations, 3 cutoff units, 1 offline annealing furnace, 1 pickle tank, 2 straighteners, and 3 polishers. Through the years, we have developed a specific know-how in stainless specialties that gives us today a very impressive range of special applications and case histories to share. For the food and beverage industry, we supply tubing in 304 and 316 grades to some of the largest U.S. wineries. We are also qualified to supply InBev Breweries, which now owns Anheuser-Busch in the United States. And we should not forget tubes supplied for canneries such as Del Monte and many others in the fruit and vegetable sector. We also supply the United States' largest poultry processing companies, Tyson, Perdue, and Pilgrim's Pride. In the oil and gas industry, we have developed a specific competence, and we are now one of the largest tube producers in North America to participate in the oil sands extraction sector. In terms of alloys, I have listed some of those we supply to these products. You'll see here 304, 316, 2205 duplex, AL6XN, and 254 SMO. For these specific grades, our volumes grew 75% from 2010 to 2011, mostly from projects related to the oil and gas sector. We can mention our contribution to projects by Shell, GE, Iola Water, HPD, and Anhydro-Dieter, who are among the biggest oil and engineering companies in the United States and North America. And not only have we expanded the number of alloys we process, but we have also produced tubing and longer lengths to meet our customers' ever-growing requirements. We are now capable of producing a tube up to 85 feet in length, which is 25.9 meters, which was unheard of just a few years ago. Moving on to heat exchanger tubing, we expect markets to grow further in 2012, not only due to a strengthening economy, but also because there has been a substantial lack of new investment during the last several years. And now companies will be forced to make new investments rather than simply repairing old units. We can provide heat exchanger, condenser tubing, all of the alloys mentioned before for the oil sands, plus nickel 200, alloy 825, 800, and all the others you see listed here. In addition to that, one of our most recent projects has been the supply of the majority of stainless pipe for two new production plants of the world's largest microprocessor manufacturer in the United States, which was in the state of Oregon and Arizona, just recently undertaken in the fourth quarter 2011 and first quarter 2012. Apart from stainless specialties, let me briefly introduce our new galvanized clear coating line in Munhall. This line will enable us to produce tubing from 1.315 to 2.375 inches in outside diameter and up to 3 millimeters in wall thickness, to service particularly the fencing industry in the specifications you see listed here. It's ASTM F1083, F1043, and A513. We are using pre-galvanized strip, then applying and curing a clear organic coating that is free of the hazardous and carcinogenic chromates that are often found in the marketplace. We expect to supply nearly 20,000 tons of these products within the next 12 months. We will also service, aside from fencing, industries such as conveyor rolls, animal containment, agriculture, scaffolding, and torsion bars for garage doors. In terms of new quality projects, in addition to already being ISO/TS certified, we are working to obtain our PED, that is Pressure Equipment Directive certification, which is necessary to supply the European markets. So, for our new market development, we are now looking more closely to opportunities overseas, both to Europe and to the Middle East, where we see huge potential and a competitive edge for our specialty projects. And of course, for global customers, such as the biggest names of the beverage industry, where we are working today, for example, to develop special small diameter coil tubing to be used worldwide. I thank you very much for your attention. We'll be available at the booth all afternoon if you have any questions. And thank you very much for your participation and your attention. Thank you.